Imagine you bought 10,000 units of US dollars in exchange for euro, or let's just say you opened a buy trade on euro USD with one mini lot. So you bought 10,000 units at 1.07741 and then the price moved to 1.18280 where you sold those 10,000 units. Or let's just say you closed the trade. Now to calculate your profit or the price movement, you will have to subtract the price at which you bought the currency from the current price of the currency, which is 1.18280 minus 1.107741, and that gives you 0.10539. So we can say that the price increased by 0.10539, and now to calculate the profit, you will have to multiply the units with this number, which gives you around $1,054. Now, are you able to recall the number or the math we just did? No, it is hard, and it won't be easy for us to always do such complex calculations. Most people hate math. Now, not only this, there are many different currencies in the world, out of which there are 8 major currencies in the Forex market. So, if a trader trades in any of the currency pair, is it easy or even possible for him to remember every small value of each currency? Obviously not. It is not possible for him to remember every value. Therefore, to make it easy to calculate the price movement, a standardized unit was introduced and it was called pip. So a pip is short for percentage in point or price interest point, and in Forex we measure the movement of a currency pair and all the profit and losses in pips. Well, pip is not the only smallest measure. Later on, after a few years, the pipet was introduced, which is even a smaller value of pip, or the fraction of pip. Like on the screen, you can see the market watchlist section. Now here, in front of every symbol, there is a value, which is also called the quote. Here you can see that at the end of the quoted value, there is a small number. This number or value is called a pipet. And in Forex, when we calculate pip, we always have to exclude pipet. Now, let us take some examples and learn how to measure pips. Let us say USD CAD was at 1.13300 and then it moved to 1.3400. So now you can say that this pair moved by 100 pips. Now, let's take another example. Let's say USD JPY was at 110.35 and then it moved to 111.00. Now, this means that USD JPY did a movement of 65 pips. So here, if you would have entered a buy trade, then you would have had a profit of 65 pips. And if you would have entered a sell trade, then you would have had a loss of 65 pips. And the profit and loss are further calculated based on the lot size which you are using. By the way, if you don't know what lot size is, you can check it out by clicking the I button. Luckily, in all the trading platforms, there are certain measurement tools that help you measure the pips, and you won't have to always do the complex calculations. Like on TradingView, to measure the pip, all you need to do is select this tool over here and start measuring. Like on TradingView, to measure the pip, all you need to do is select this tool over here and start measuring. Like if we calculate the price movement from this point to this level, you can see over here, this is a price movement of around 50 pips and it is mentioned over here.